Auto focus, there we go. So what we're attempting to make here, this is called a snake drive. This is the snake flex drive, and it comes with these little, where are those parts at, Jason? See if I can, So that goes on there just like that, and then there's a set screw, and then on the other side that goes in there just like that. Then the shaft, you can run it through a sheathing or whatever, but on the other side you have this here, and this particular one, bring it back over if you don't mind, that's 3 millimeters, and that just happened. Now that doesn't fit Futaba, and it doesn't fit High Tech or anything else. I mean, the only one it's screwed into is this, and you're going to have a Metal Gear servo. But then this goes straight in here, and you put a set screw in there. So when this turns, so does this whole cable. So you can run this thing any way you want to be able to operate your throttle or anything else, really. And that was the snake system. The sad thing is they quit making them. So, like I said, we had bought some brass stock, and we were going to start cutting them, drilling them, making our own primitively with a drill press. And we found these ferrules here that these go on the boat drive cables. And I think this one here would probably go on the hard shaft that comes out through here. So anyway, but this is for a larger cable. That's not for the eighth inch. That's the only drawback, but we've got it. We've got an idea figured out. Now, I ordered these standoffs, the same kind of standoffs that you use on the drones that come in plastic or nylon or whatever. Okay, but these are brass. This one here has got a 4 millimeter hex. So you would need a 4 millimeter wrench to wrench that. I think this thing is 10 millimeter overall, and the threads are about 6 millimeter long, but it's got that M3 thread on it. That's the big hurdle, finding out, you know, finding the right stuff to use. Now they make these in 4 millimeter hex, 6 millimeter hex, 10 millimeter hex, and of course they make the standoffs in all different sizes, and they come with all different threads. You can get them on American, and you can get them in metric. You want to order a minimum of a 6 millimeter, which is this size right here that came with this originally. You see all that extra meat that you got there? So when you drill, you got something to tap into. Unfortunately, the 4 millimeter, you don't have any meat there when you run that 1/8 cable into it. So because we're in a bind, what I'm going to do is we're going to solder with our solder pot, and we're just going to solder this on there and then attach it on the other side. So if you'll order the 6 millimeter, or I would even say the 10 millimeter, the threads that you need, then you can make these with your boat drive shaft cables. And these things, it's just, especially if you got a tight spot or if you got a place where you can't really get. I'll think of it as soon as I... Bell crank, that's the one. Okay, so anyway, let us get to soldering on this, and we'll see how it comes out. Get some flux on it. The flux capacitor. MAP gas. I tried the other gas, just regular propane. It didn't work. I don't know why. Don't want to get this stuff too hot. Too hot, it starts rolling off. Okay, so we're gonna put flux here. Need some new flux, man. You know, flux can get contaminated. Now, let's see here. We have this here. I'm gonna clean off the top of my solder. Just to get me a little spot there where I don't have anything contaminated. Where's that rag, boss?
Right here.
Okay, cool. All right. Again, not too much heat. About all you need, I think. And we're going to stick that in there and just start rolling. Now you can make a crucible. You don't have to have this fancy tool. Let's see how that works. I'm going to go in here and re-dip because there's nothing better than a double dip cone. Go ahead and turn that thing off. I don't need it hot forever. Alright. We want to get all them boogers out of there. Alright. Back. Three slices of cheese. Please. Okay. I'm going to clean this off one more time. So you can take a nut or a big nut and a big bolt like this, that'll, you know, a big bolt that'll stand on the table, and screw that nut on there, you know, two or three times, and get it hot with some map gas and fill it up with this here, the silver solder, and you'll have, you know, where the threads are, you'll have that thing just floating in solder. It makes a great crucible, and it works just like this here. You just don't have electric control over the temperature. All right, so let's marry these two. Hopefully we didn't get that stuff on our threads. And see, you just touch it with the heat. It doesn't take much. I've never been able to get this to work with a soldering iron. Oh, that's not good. Look at that. We got solder on our deal, right?
Yeah.
So no worries, we got 100 of them here. And the hard part's over with because we've got solder on our cable. So instead of doing it like I did it, I'm gonna do it like I didn't do it. Starting to work now. Okay, bada bing, bada boom. Now we can take a soldering gun and we'll clean that up, but that's not going anywhere. So now, and you'll want to use, we're still trying to figure this out ourselves, so, but I'm guessing, you know, you're going to want to use red Loctite. You dig?
Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
Screw that in there with some red Loctite. Tighten it down real taut. Now, whenever that servo turns, this is going to turn. And whenever this is turning, and it's attached to this ferrule like that, and that's attached to your carburetor, you know what happens. And that, my friends, is the snake drive system that these cats came out with. Now, I want to give credit where credit's due. I tried to call these guys Just trying to see if I could find, if I could buy a set. These guys were out of Washington, looks like. Unique Designs and Development. There was a couple of their names. Okay. So I Googled their names, and the first thing that come up was obituaries. So I did call the numbers. The phone number disconnected. I think the 1-800 number went to some low fantasy thing. I don't know. Who knows? But anyway, this is the original kit I bought. Came in some stuff, and I've been holding on to this thing for about 2 or 3 years. And we never used it. You know, take a look at that there. And apparently they made sets for different motors. There's one for YS. Back up now. So anyway, credit's done where credit's due. If you have high-tech servos, or if you have Futaba servos, there again, I guess you could use plastic, but you're not going to be able to get the machine threads. You can find out what the thread size is for those, because when I was looking them up, I couldn't find the thread size for these, but I could find them for high-tech and Futaba. And I forget what I found around here that screwed in. Oh, I think I found a machine bolt that was actually in a package that had the right number on it. But we'll get all this put together and let y'all take a look at it after we got it all zipped up and everything. See this twin engine bad boy, see how she works. All right, man. Oh, man.
So what do you want the here?
Garbage.
All right. We should have done a video on that damn tape.
Yeah, we should have. That was pretty cool.
That was a how-to right there.
That was a how-to. That was a how to save your butt. So I just spent, 10 minutes videotaping something with all this piss and vinegar and happiness, man, and I didn't have the record button hit. I got to do this quick because my battery's about to die, but look at that pretty stuff. Oh. Okay, so we've got our steering servos in place. Now that you can see how this is going to kind of run when that goes through there, that's going to run right into that furrow right down there, and then the other one's going to run right down through here, super clean. So depending on how many people ask me, we may start kitting these things up. I want to give credit where credit's due and talk to the to see if I can find anything, any information at all on the people that originally came up with this idea. But I like it, and I can see where it would work great on cars, boats, and planes, and dirigibles, and ornithopters, and puppy dogs. Y'all be good. I gotta go charge my batteries. Chomper, charge your batteries. Charge your batteries. Does a puppy dog. Let's see here. All right, now that we got the box mocked up, we're going to pull it out. Jason's getting ready to drill holes in the fiberglass bathtub / hot tub. And we'll probably JB weld in a piece of metal aluminum tubing right here that this nylon tubing, Teflon, will go through. That's too small. I think there's some bigger stuff. You can use like that there. Try that stuff there. There you go. Pesky tape. You don't really need the Teflon inside here, really, from just like, just out here where your fingers can get caught in it or whatever. You just want to kind of protect it up almost all the way to the carburetor. And is there, you got a piece of aluminum in there? Aluminum tubing? No, it's going to be, it was in there. There it is right there. It's hiding. See it? There's some more set screws there too for one of them ferrules.
Yes, the couple.
No, right there too, huh? And this is the stuff they originally sent with the snake kit. Vibratite thread fastener prevents loosening due to shock or vibration. I'm sure that red Loctite will suffice.
Yes.
How to use Vibratite? You use scissors to clip off the nipple?
Yeah, I would.
With the nozzle, you spread the Vibratite completely around the male threads, leaving the female alone. Let's see, threads should be at least half full of this Vibratite when dry. Allow it to dry long enough to create a gripping, which will begin in about 10 to 30 minutes. Drying time will depend on the size of the part. Well, I wonder if that's before you screw it in or after. Probably after. Danger. Try chloroethane. If swallowed, do not induce vomiting. I wonder why they don't want you to vomit when you swallow stuff, man. Anyway, so we'll get back on you here in a little bit when there's an update to be updated.